all of humanity. It's really a joy and a pleasure to be out here in nature and bring this message of emancipation to you, pointing you to look within to discover your higher self. And when you discover your higher self, you discover your true identity to be your divinity. Now, I want to continue speaking concerning the Ten Commandments. And I will have spoken about the first commandment, whereby it says, thou shalt have no other God besides me. And I'm telling you that you can never say me and not referring to yourself. Okay, so it's teaching you basically how to believe in yourself and trust in yourself, because God is within you. Now, the second commandment is like unto the first commandment, where it says that thou shalt not take the Lord thy God name in vain. So it is teaching you that when you know who is God, you will know the name of God also. So now let's look in the Bible in Exodus chapter 3. And before I elaborate on Exodus chapter 3, I want to let you know that my teaching is based on the fact that the Bible addresses the human mind and must be interpreted psychologically. That the Bible is not literal, neither is the Bible secular history, and that the Bible was written symbolically. Therefore, my brothers and my sisters, when we look at Exodus chapter 3, we see that the name of God is I Am. And the reason why the name of God is I Am, it is because the universal question of life is, who am I? And when the answer comes, it must be I Am. And it is said in Exodus chapter 3, that I am that I am, which means to say that I am whatever I believe myself to be, for as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. And the question was asked by Moses, what is your name, that I may tell those whom you're sending me to your name? And remember, Moses just means to be born. It is basically showing you you of your birth, where you were birthed into slavery, because your body is a slave to the mind, and you're trapped in this three-dimensional world and must break out of the three dimension and go into other dimensions by discovering your higher self. So when we come to realize that the name of God is I Am, we have to be careful how we use the name I Am. So when you get this truth, you do not go about saying that I am broke, or I have luck, or I am suffering, or I am sick, or I am weak, or I am nervous. Whenever you use the name of I Am, you want to say something positive. Whenever you use the name of I Am, you want to believe that you are using the name of God, and that you must never desecrate the name of God by attaching anything negative to I Am. So my brother and my sister, it's very important for you to use I Am affirmation by saying, I am rich, I am abundance, I am more than sufficient, okay, I am intelligent, I am God. All of these I Ams, use them in a positive way and claim those things that you so desire in your life that will bring you into that heavenly place. Because we are to dwell in heavenly places in Christ, which is our higher self. So, my brother and my sisters, these commandments, they all are showing you that the Bible is your own biography, and that all you have to do is to look inwardly. All of these commandments is teaching you how to live your life triumphantly. All of these commandments are teaching you that everything works by laws, and that there are universal laws that govern the universe and govern the rest of humanity. That's the reason why you have to govern your mind to operate in the right frequency, vibration, knowing that and vibration, knowing that everything is energy. So here, these commandments is teaching you how to focus your mind. These commandments are teaching you how to think rightly. These commandments are teaching you how you're supposed to live your life in awareness, and how the power of awareness would allow you to align yourself with the God frequency. that you will be able to operate from your God self, that you will be able to operate from the sixth sense. So first of all, it is saying, the first commandment is saying to believe in yourself. The second one is saying to believe in your true identity, your name. Understanding the name. Don't call the name of the Lord thy God name in vain. Okay? So my brother and my sisters, it is basically teaching you your oneness with God. It's teaching you that you and God are one. So many people who do not understand these commandments and do not understand that Moses is speaking about their own self and that the Bible is their own biography, they're the ones who go about interpreting the Bible as if the Bible is literal and as if the Bible is secular history. Therefore, they're buying burdens upon themselves, trying to gain salvation through works, not knowing that true salvation is self-realization, and not knowing that there's nothing you can do to gain this kind of love, because this kind of love is agape love, and this agape love, which is God love, is unconditional love. Therefore, if there is such a thing as grace, and grace is unmerited favor or unconditional love, then it is basically teaching you that there is no right and there is no wrong. It is teaching you that these commandments are teaching you how to walk with the laws that governs your human journey, because we are spirit having a human experience. So it is teaching you these commandments that you would live a triumphant life and that you will be able to overcome the system of this world and live a life as one who is in dominion and authority, having control over his mind and knowing how to lead and guide himself in the right path of life, understanding the golden rule of life, to do unto others as you have them do unto you. And when you first of all get to know who you are and why you are here. So once you understand the first commandment, you'll be able to understand the second commandment also. Okay, and then you'll be able to understand the third and the fourth and so on, right up to those 10 commandments that religion holds to, such as the Seventh-day Adventists, and pin on people as burdens because they do not understand that the Bible addresses the human mind and must be interpreted psychologically. They still believe that the Bible is literal and that the Bible is secular history. So with that being said, my brother and my sister, I want to just encourage you, according to the first commandment, to love and embrace yourself, and to the second commandment, to know exactly who you are and to use your power and do not misuse the power by desecrating the name of God, which is your name, and to know your identity and walk in the power of your identity, because that is your royalty. So with that being said, my brother and my sister, I want to thank you very much, and I just want to encourage you, if you haven't subscribed already, to subscribe, or you can like, you can support this channel by sharing this message also. And I want to encourage you to follow me on Instagram also at Black Mad Guru, and also to check out my blogs on my website blackmadguru.com. So let me say that again, my website is blackmadguru.com, and I have a lot of interesting blogs. I would like you to check them out and read them. All you have to do, go on the website and you click on blogs, and you will read, you know, much blogs and even the comments of those who would have read them before, because it's all about enlightening and bringing value to all of humanity. So with that being said, my brother and my sister, I just want to remind you that this message I bring to you is the single eye message of self-realization, of which Matthew 6:22 says, if your eye be single, your whole body be full of light. That's the reason why I always give you the symbol of the single eye, letting you know that when you have the experience, you come to realize that it is the rising of the S-U-N in a S-O-N, and that is the dawning of a new day in your life, and that the S-U-N parallels the human imagination, and the human imagination parallels the sun. For without the sun, there is no life and there is no light. And without the human imagination, there is anything made that was made. And the sun is what powers all of humanity. Therefore, my brother and my sisters, my encouragement to you is to use your mind power, which is your solar power, to achieve your every desire. So with that being said, I want to say peace. Love you all. I'm out.